So say you're having trouble with your computer. What's the one piece of advice you can expect almost any expert to tell you right off the bat? It may be to go over here and to restart your computer. Or as one TV show always said, have you tried turning it off and then on again? So why does restarting your computer solve so many computer problems? Well, the reason it does is because you don't really need to restart your computer. All you really need to do in a lot of cases is restart the app or process that is causing you a problem. But figuring out what app or process that is can take a long time, much longer than just simply restarting your computer, which will restart all of your apps and all the processes and everything going on, solving the problem, which may have just been one little thing. So it's a bit of an overkill, but it's quicker to do that than it is to actually figure out the problem. So to give an example, here in the dock you can see I've got Safari running, I've got Mail running, I've got Photos running, I've got all sorts of things going on. So maybe I'm having an issue and it's one of these apps that's causing the problem. I could try quitting each one and see if it solves the issue, but a restart is just faster, especially if you've got like 10 or 20 apps going on. In addition, if you look at Activity Monitor, you'll see that you've got way more than that going on. There's a lot of background apps that are running, tons of them. So it could be that one of those is causing you an issue, especially if you have lots of third-party apps, because you may have all the basic stuff that all comes from Apple. But then if you've got, say, 10 or 20 third-party apps, then you've got 10 or 20 different pieces of software from different companies, different development environments, all running on your Mac. One of them could be causing a problem, and it could be the thing that's stopping everything from working on your Mac. By restarting, you're clearing all of that out, forcing all of those apps and processes to restart, which may fix the one that's having an issue. Even if you feel you're not doing much on your Mac, you really are. That list of things in Activity Monitor is showing you that there's lots of network activity because you're contacting the internet, you're loading things on web pages. A single web page could contain 50 or 100 different items that have to be loaded separately. You have to maintain a Wi-Fi connection. There's system updates, there's software updates, there's all sorts of things going on in the background monitoring your computer and what's going on. Any one of those could have an issue. And the more third-party software you've got installed, the more of these that you're going to have running in the background, even if you're not using these apps and even if they're not running at the current time. The only time I would worry about restarts is when you've done it too much. When is too much? Well, I'd say if you're restarting more than once a week, then it's probably too much. Now, you may know why you're restarting. You may have a piece of beta software or development software or something that you know is causing the issue. And then that's fine. Then restart as often as you need, as often as you are willing to put up with to use that software. But if you don't think you're using anything that should be causing issues and you're still having to restart to clear out problems, then you may want to have somebody take a look at your Mac. Maybe take it to the Genius Bar so they can investigate and figure out what is causing the issue that makes you have to restart all the time. And maybe you can fix it, or maybe just simply uninstall the piece of software that is getting in the way.